The first term exam, I scored 1 out of 100 marks. I was completely humiliated and I decided, okay, I am going to quit. And I dropped out of school. Jo hai wahan pe drop out kar diya. I was 50% clear that mujhe kya nahi karna hai, ye mujhe samajh aa chuka tha. But mujhe kya karna hai, that was yet to be discovered. I was completely broke. I was not having the money to support my family. Never, never, never give up. Even if you are going through hell, keep on walking. Ek din aayega, hell bhi piche reh jayega. From a class 11 dropout to becoming a chartered accountant, then becoming penniless, and then becoming a successful edtech entrepreneur. This is my story. My name is Neeraj Arora. I am a teacher by passion and a chartered accountant by profession. Today, I'm going to share 3 incidents of my life that completely changed my life. And in incidents ka meri life pe bahut bahut zabardast impact raha. In 2002, I cleared my class 10th exams. And then I was very keen on joining science stream. The reason is that everyone was joining science stream. Everyone was saying that once you clear your class 10, join science, become engineer, your life is sorted. So I also did the same. My school was not giving me science stream. I changed my school and shifted to another school because of the reason that they were giving me the science stream. And after the first term, it was very much clear that it is not my cup of tea. What happened? My first terminal exam was in September 2002. So the first exam went really, really, really bad. I just write a single line on that paper. And after 10 days of that paper, my class teacher called me up in the assembly. And he just, unhone aise haath rakh diya mere upar. And he just said, meet Mr. Neeraj Arora. He's a class 11th A student. And he scored 1 out of 100 in chemistry. Everyone was making fun of me. जो छोटे बच्चे थे वो भी मुझसे ऐसे पूछते थे भैया आप वही हो ना जिसने एक नंबर स्कोर किया था अपने क्लास 11 के केमिस्ट्री के एग्जाम में. सो मैं बहुत कम आई वॉज कम्प्लीटली ह्यूमिलेटेड एंड आई डिसाइडेड कि ओके आई एम गोइंग टू क्विट. और मैंने अपना स्कूल जो है वहाँ पर ड्रॉप आउट कर दिया. Just because of this dropout, it was a big disappointment to my family. So I started going to my father's office just to compensate this disappointment. And after going to my father's office for 2 months, I met one person who was a chartered accountant. And he just said me one thing. Okay, at least complete your basic education. Don't do graduation. Don't do post-graduation. Just complete your basic education. And if you're not able to score good marks in science, go for commerce. So what I did, I just went back to that school and I selected commerce as my stream. I remember the very first day of my commerce section. So there was a chapter depreciation which was going on, and the teacher was explaining depreciation, machinery account. DR was written on one side, CR was written on one side, and what I thought, the DR stands for doctor and CR stands for compounder. And I asked the same question to my friends and they were laughing at me again. So I decided ke, okay, I will work hard and will try to score good marks in commerce. But I scored only 40% marks in class 11. I worked hard and I converted this 40% to 80% in class 12th. And after doing my class 12th, I decided that I will go for a course which is known as chartered accountancy. So what are the key takeaways from this incident of my life? The number one key takeaway is whatever happens, happens for a great cause. Sometimes I just think that what would be my future agar maine science li hoti aur maine science drop out nahi kiya hota. To agar science drop out nahi karta, commerce leta, to mera future aaj kuch different hi hota. Second key takeaway is duniya ka sabse bada rog kya kahenge log. I selected science just because everyone else was doing it, just because my friends were doing it, just because people said your life will be sorted. So never do this. Do a proper research before you select a course, before you select a profession. You need to do a proper research. Moving on to the second incident, that is my CA final direct tax exam. CA final has got 8 exams and the 7th number is direct taxation. Direct taxation is a very vast subject. Just to give you a ready reference, you need to learn 1500 pages. You need to study 1500 pages for a single exam. And syllabus bahut bada hai, to exam bhi kafi lengthy hota hai. So it was my 7th exam of CA final in November 2010. I used to go to my examination center with my own car. So the car broke in the middle and I was late by 25 minutes. And I took 5 minutes to settle down. All in all, I was late by 30 minutes in a paper jo waise ek bilkul ocean ki tarah lagta hai. Anyhow, I started writing and I kept on writing till 5 p.m. That was the time allowed. And then I went back to my home and I started preparing for the next exam. That was my last exam. Yes, there were some apprehensions ki main fail ho jaunga, but koi baat nahi, maine apna last exam achhi tarah prepare karke diya. And the result came on 21st January 2011. I just looked at my direct taxes marks and it was 60. Scoring 60 marks in chartered accountancy is equal to scoring a century in cricket. So what are the key takeaways from this incident? The key takeaways are, Number one, never, never, never give up. Even if you are going through hell, keep on walking. Ek din aayega, hell bhi piche reh jayega. Lekin agar aap hell mein hi ruk gaye, so just think over it. Aap wahin pe ruk gaye. So it's better, keep on walking. Number two, ghabrana nahi hai. Sunne mein bahut asaan lagta hai, do not panic. But it is very important. Because in situations like this, when you are half an hour late for your exam, the first thing you do is panic. So don't panic, just be calm and do your work. After becoming chartered accountant, I joined as an assistant manager accounts and finance in the corporate world, and I worked there for 7 days. I gave my resignation on the 8th day. After leaving that company, I joined a CA firm, and then I worked there for 1.5 months, and I gave the resignation again. I was 50% clear that मुझे क्या नहीं करना है, ये मुझे समझ आ चुका था. But मुझे क्या करना है, that was yet to be discovered. So when I joined my chartered accountancy course, I started teaching students of class 11th and class 12th way back in 2007. Then after leaving the CA firm and the corporate job, I decided that I will go for teaching. And I got associated with Institute of Chartered Accountants of India as the visiting faculty of taxation and auditing. It went very well for 2 years. But in 2013, because of some internal issues with the institute, I dropped out as a faculty of the taxation and auditing from Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. And again, I was completely clueless. What next? But as they say, whatever happens for a great cause. I just discovered that teaching is my true love, and I can teach on and on and on for hours and hours, for days and days, for years to come. Then I decided to go with my own venture, that is Neeraj Arora Classes. On 1st July 2013, I started Neeraj Arora Classes with 5 students only. And when I look back, there were only 5 students, but now there are 5 lakh students across the globe who are connected with us through our YouTube channel or through our other websites and applications. In 2016, I realized the potential of technology and its impact on education, and therefore we decided to build websites and apps for commerce students and for education purposes. We went for a website and we developed an app known as EDU91, on which right now 2 lakh students are enrolled for different courses ranging from taxation, auditing, and how to write your resume, how to face an interview, etc., etc. So the key takeaway from the third incident is do what you love. I remember the Steve Jobs commencement address of Stanford in 2005. He particularly said, your work is going to fill a large part of your life, and the only way to be truly satisfied is to do great work. And the only way to do great work is to love what you do. This is what I followed. I love teaching, and I started teaching without anything in mind that I will earn or I will not earn. In 2013, I was completely penniless. I was completely broke. I was not having the money to support my family. But then my true love, that is teaching, came in, and I started teaching without any fear. Think big. Think really big. I started with 5 students, and now there are 5 lakh students which are connected with me. Why? Because I have a dream that, okay, I want to get in touch with as many students as possible, and I want to give them value. So think big, think really big. Please do not restrict yourself. And the third key takeaway from this incident is, please go and invest in your technology. If you are a student, invest in technology. If you are an entrepreneur, invest in technology, because this is going to work for you. You cannot expand, you cannot diversify if you are not investing in technology. I have learned, please don't stop at failures. Failure is not the end. It is just the beginning. Always try to convert your weaknesses into your strength. Just look at my journey. Science side failure, commerce stream, chartered accountant. CA 2011, penniless 2013, then becoming an edtech entrepreneur. So life will always, always try to put you down, but you have to pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and start again. This is the ultimate key takeaway from this story, and I hope you will get inspired and you will also do big things in your life. And in the end, I would like to say, jaisa main hamesha kehta hoon, seekhte rahe, kyunki seekhna band to jeetna band.
Tell us what you think about this video, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.